Recently, I rediscovered the Oxford Book of Friendship, Quentin Bryce's Christmas gift to our family in 1992. Among many gems was the reference to Testament of Friendship by Vera Brittain, who was interested in the ideas and attitudes about women's friendships. Her book was published in 1940 in honour of her friend Winifred Holtby. I love this snippet. From the days of Homer, the friendships of men have enjoyed glory and acclamation, but the friendships of women, in spite of Ruth and Naomi, have usually been not merely unsung, but mocked and belittled and falsely interpreted. I hope that Winifred's story may do something to destroy these tarnished interpretations and show its readers that loyalty between women is a noble relationship which, far from impoverishing, actually enhances the love of a girl for her lover, of a wife for her husband, of a mother for her children. Some feminine individualists believe they flatter men by fostering the fiction of a woman's jealous inability to love and respect each other. Other sceptics, aroused by any record of affection between women, to suspicions habitual to the oversophisticated. Although we did not grow up together, we grew mature together, and that is the next best thing. Women of the 70s might say the same. The grandmothers are coming. As I learned from growing up, you don't mess with your grandmother. Prince William. I wanted the last words to be about grandmothers. I recall a speech I gave in 2015 about ageing and how I had found an article in The Atlantic comparing menopause in mammals. It was a great story and stayed with me. I went to the Current Biology Journal looking for updates.